I know. Freaky Soleil. Freaky Soleil.
Tell us about your influence. Like, you're an influencer. So what made you pick these brands, work with these brands that you so heavily stand behind, and, like, you know, dedicate yourself to these pieces of art? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, two major brands that I definitely love to represent, literally like a badge of honor. One of them is my best friend's mom. Mm-hmm. It's a mezbah. It's called Hugo Mezbah. Mm-hmm. It's off of Helmont. Up there in Jersey Village, like Cypress area.
Okay.
She actually, for the last 3 years, has been helping me physically transition, like with my face and everything. Yeah. So I've had like fillers, Botox, and all non-surgical procedures on my face to further feminize my face. So I honestly really thank her for everything. She's like a second mom to me. She's really been there. She takes care of me. She loves me. Her daughter, Cameron, is one of my best friends that I went to high school with. So they're definitely like another family to me.
You know, Vibe, I guess, like, you must have been really lonely and scared and just concerned about life, like, going through, you know, like, I think your beauty radiates, like, the amount of, the reason why we see you as a beautiful person, the reason why I see Adalina as a beautiful person is that I think you've been through a lot. Mm.
Yes. Leg out.
Here's the time.
It's the pressure of the diamond has to
go through. Yeah.
And we are still in this path, in this journey.
Yeah, it's
We're
beautiful.
We're working on it every day.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
One more thing you like to represent that you think is a good representation of yourself? Like, what is something that you do or that you have planned for yourself?
Well, definitely, I do still want to get my degree and earning career in the medical field. If for whatever reason modeling and being an influencer just doesn't work out and I just can't do it anymore, I want to fall back on the medical field. So yeah. I definitely want to
be a nurse or a doctor.
I want to be a nurse. I want to be a cosmetic injector, do fillers and Botox and things like that.
Yes.
And hopefully in the future work alongside and partially own a med spa, run it alongside some plastic surgeons and really make some money in that field and really like change people's lives.
Do that.
Bet. I like that.
I know some people in school right now. Here in the Houston area, and like who are wanting to expand as well and build. So, like, I commend you. Like, do that all the way.
I even say,
do it while you're still being an influencer. Like, just like you said, you have that to fall back on, but you can do it simultaneously. Like, I love
bringing
that.
Bringing people through your journey.
Yes.
Like, that will create a connection with your fans.
Yeah. And help them want more too. Like, you know, just have better and be better and put better things out there in the universe, in the environments that we live in, you know? Yeah. So, like, you know, tend to the soil a little bit.
Yes. But you actually have some experience as well, right?
Yeah.
So
what are
you working in
the cosmetic?
Yeah, cosmetic.
Yeah, I used to work for some plastic surgeons, and then, of course, again, my friend's mom, like, always being in there, her working on me, things like that. And also the medical field is something I'm very, very interested in. Like, it really intrigues me. I did finish medical school. I'm a licensed medical
Lego. Tony up!
Congratulations! That's dope.
Mm.
Have a party.
She's got brains. She's hot. So why are you still single then? Before we get into that, why would you expect... I mean, I just want, you know, because there might be some transgender people out here. We're going to take a quick break. Ladies and gentlemen, this is AfroVibes Worldwide Radio. My name is Heaven Motzart, expensive shit. You're on AfroVibes Radio 2 Club. I'm here with Soleil. I'm here with Daniela. And our guest today is the beautiful, gorgeous Adalina. Adalina is a transgender model. Trust me, daddy, when you see her, you're not going to know. That's right. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. That's right. My name is Heaven Motzart. We'll be right back for everyone. We're going to talk about what is the transgender community like in Houston? And is, you know, where can, if you're looking to transition, because when Adalina decided to, before she transitioned, she didn't have help. And what's the name of that? Mexico City?
Brownsville
in Texas? Brownsville. You know, whatever, Brownsville. That's right. This is... But Adalina's here in Houston. She didn't make it in Brownsville. She's making it here right now. That's why she's got medical degrees.
Come on,
she's modeling.
Yeah.
That's why she's you know, healthy. What she she's what we call it? Is she a meal or a snack?
Well,
she's a whole meal.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five more, I mean, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Adalina's in the building. What's up, Adalina? Damn. Trust me, I'm gonna take you away. Check 1, 2, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Afrovise Worldwide Radio. Just, you know, please pardon my speech. I did go out last night. I'm so litty. I have not slept. That's right, because I'm busy daydreaming about Adalina. Adalina.
Ski, ski.
Lego.
So Adalina, how...
At least one.
I have not slept at all. Ladies and gentlemen, please pull up on me tonight. I'm at Azura. That's right. I'm trying to get Soleil to go out. You know Soleil doesn't go out. She's always at church.
That's right.
I promise. I'll play a church song. I'll play four church songs if you come out tonight.
I'm good. I'll come. I got to do schoolwork, though. I'm getting my degree, so I'm getting my MBA. So, you know, I got to handle my business, baby. You know what I'm saying?
No time.
I'm going to make time, though.
No time for
that.
So, Adalina, you know, why don't you describe, you know, like, what, you know, some of the... Like, what are your saddest moments? You know, I just, you know, like, because I don't think some of our listeners, you know, like, some of our listeners across the seas, whether it be in Africa, they don't know what a transgender is. You know, they're clueless to these things. America's a very good country, or, you know, and it allows, and you know, you could be whoever you want to be. But some of our listeners, they don't know how it is. And some of our listeners want to transition, but they don't know what to do. So, I think I want our listeners to feel the pain that you went through before you decided, like, you know what? I'm gonna free myself. I'm gonna take charge. I want people to feel like the pain you went through, where you were all alone and everyone's just acting the fool and not doing anything to help you and busy judging you. What was that pain like?
Your journey. Take us on your journey with you,
Well, the toughest times of my life definitely were in middle school. I was like actually like getting beaten up, jumped and bullied. Mostly for just being gay, like being like a very feminine boy. Mm-hmm. back in Brownsville was just not like very acceptable at all. Like they definitely looked down on you.
Yeah.
Getting like beaten up in the bathrooms, getting things thrown at me, and then even sometimes the teachers would watch and not even say anything.
Wow. Boo. Wow. Shame on the teachers.
Should we curse out one of your old teachers? Give me one of your old teachers' name.
Well, definitely my old band director, Mr. Gato.
was he an asshole?
Yeah, no, he actually would pick on the kids too.
Mr. Cantu?
That's horrible.
Mr. Cantu, you're a douchebag.
Horrible.
If you're listening to them, Mr. Cantu, douchebag,
for
picking on Adalina.
You need to look. Karma is a real thing. I'm just gonna say it. You need to grow. Okay. Mm-hmm. Change your life and do better.
Yeah, so American kids basically suck at everything. When they go to school, they're picking on people, fighting. They, you know, but it's supposed to be the land of the free, but you're still picking on people.
Yeah, there are some good ones. So, like, just like your best friend, you know, you said you've been with them for a while. Like, there are some good educators, but the bad ones, y'all gotta do better.
Yeah, so definitely, I did try to commit suicide in middle school. I was like 11.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why, you slit your wrist?
No, I tried to hang myself in my closet, but the shirt ripped. When I was
in Thank you, Jesus.
For real.
You see, wow. if that shirt didn't rip, we won't be seeing all
that's
of this. All of this.
Wow.
You want to hide all of this fire now?
How did you handle? Sorry.
I would not know how to handle it.
How did you handle that? Like,
yeah, once
that shirt ripped, it's like,
were you like, wow?
Yeah. Well, it definitely was like, just like a full moment for me, because when that happened, I had like MTV playing, and Lady Gaga's song had debuted Born This Way.
Come on.
At the same time.
I love the universe. Let me just say that. Like, I love the universe.
Mm-hmm.
It's nothing but the universe.
Yeah. So I literally had that song on repeat, like, and then I went outside and I walked by myself. Like it was like maybe like around like 1 a.m. or like a midnight. And I just had the song playing, and I just like bawled my ass on outside.
So are you spiritual?
Yeah.
Go ahead. Are you? Girl, look, I got so many questions.
Please.
Let's talk about it.
We're connected right now. Okay.
We're connected with
you. Are you spiritual? Like, do you consider yourself a spiritual being?
Yeah, I'm very spiritual. I did grow up Catholic, so there are some things that, you know, with also that I still like focus on, I still believe in.
Mm-hmm.
There are some other things that I don't, but I definitely kind of like mix the two of it.
Yeah. So kind of like breaking away from the religion and more so like focusing on the spirituality, the true essence of it, you know, the relationship and how it moves through you. You're so beautiful. I love it. I love that.
Mm-mm. Yeah, she is beautiful.
I love that.
And like, she's single, right?
Oh.
Leg
out.
Leg out. Leg out. Leg out. Leg out. Adalina, are you single or not? Are you smashing or you're not smashing? What are you doing?
Those are two different questions, first of all. Oh, so smashing
you
don't necessarily
at the end of it, though. Ladies and gentlemen, we like smashing on the tea club, just so you know. Ski ski!
I like smashed potatoes.
I love some potatoes. Okay. French fries, you got me all the way to my heart is food.
I know the way to your heart. All I need to play some gospel.
Some potatoes, okay?
Gospel potatoes. Gospel potatoes.
Gospel potatoes.
Gospel potatoes and abandoned gay clubs.
Yes,
that's right. That's what we're talking about today. Abandoned gay clubs.
And some water. Some water.
What does an abandoned gay club look like, Adelaide?
I don't know. Like overgrown weeds, cracked cement, sidewalks, graffiti on the wall.
You gotta have the art.
For real.
Sounds like a lot of places.
Yeah. I remember, I think it was called Studio 69, and the 69 was in Rainbow.
Oh, wow.
Rainbows!
Studio
69,
I made some slushies.
So, how is the...
A rainbow slush.
How is the... I'm trying to educate myself on, you know, the transgender community and also the gay community. Trust me, it's not like I'm coming out. I do everything. I'm multiverse.
Leg out. I think freely.
That's right. Kanye West, think free. You know, but is the transgender community big in Houston?
It definitely is. If anything, we've definitely grown more since being transgender has definitely come out like people on mainstream media. Mm-hmm. That's definitely helped. And now that we're like just like busting down doors and really trying to push for like equality and definitely, you know, bring light to the fact that transgender people do exist and we are people, we are humans.
Yeah.
There's definitely still more work to be done, but we are definitely heading for
it. Yeah, you guys should invite me out when I've never been to a gay bar.
Have you been to RMCC? Resurrection Metropolitan Community Church here in Houston off West 18th Street?
Oh, you're talking about church?
It's a gay church. Like,
I don't even remember the last time I went to church.
Bro, my mom says it's an acceptance church. Okay. So,
what's the name of that church again?
RMCC, Resurrection Metropolitan Community Church. I actually love them. I've been...
Bring them through.
My mom is a member. My mom's wife, like, they've been going there for years. My mom's wife is Reverend Vicky, who just passed, but...
Rest in peace, Reverend Vicky.
Yes, like, you should, if you're a spiritual being and you want to connect more, you should definitely look out. Look at them, reach out to them, you know, even online, you know, everything going on. They're online. They have services every Sunday. If you want to, they have like community events, they have organizations, they've held vigils. They do a lot in the community for
do they have hot transgender
they are
people.
The community, they have hot people, period.
Good.
Period.
Adalina, do you know any hot transgender people, since you don't want to let us know if you're single or not?
I know a lot of beautiful trans women.
Yes, let us know.
Find you.
And if I'm talking to a transgender, so these are for all my straight men that want to talk to transgender women.
Let go.
Okay. What do I say? What do I say to you? Hey, baby.
Hey, baby.
let go.
Hey, baby, you're fire.
Hey, girl.
I'm hot.
Hey, girl.
Anissa, right now. What's the best way?
The way you would approach any other woman. Respectfully, kindly, with some manners, dignity, and respect. And that's definitely get our attention.
Damn, there's no hope for me.
No. Nowhere, Heaven. You have to like be respectful. You think that's common sense, but no, it's not. For a lot of people.
I didn't even know.
Yeah, because I just don't.
I only deal with gentlemen, I guess.
I don't follow any European or African standards. I create my own standards. Yeah. I don't feel like, oh, you're like, oh, you gotta wear this to be a good job. I have a fucking job.
Let me put myself in this little box.
Exactly. Like, I just do whatever I want. Like, right. That day, maybe the vibe is like, maybe I'm in the club with you, and maybe the vibe is like, kiss her forehead. That's what
Come
I'm
on,
gonna
I
do.
Like that. That like, is a good way.
You wanna kiss on your forehead right now?
Do you like kisses on your forehead right now?
Where
do
you like
kisses?
Where
do you like kisses? I'm fine. Kisses down low.
Lego.
We're focusing on Adalina right now. Welcome to the Tea Club at Afterwise Worldwide Radio. Adalina, we don't have too much time. You're an amazing person. We gotta hang out more often. Daniela, you need to bring her around.
Make we gotta sure go out. Are we going?
What, to church?
No, to Montrose. You said you go to Montrose, right? You want to go to Montrose. It's beautiful. I went to brunch. Over there, it's so beautiful. And RMCC.
Yep.
Stream online.
And you saw a lot of hot transgender women?
I see a lot of hot transgender women. I see a lot of hot gay men. And I'd be like, dang, you gay. And I'm not even single, but you're beautiful.
You're not single?
I told you, Heaven, I'll never be single ever again.
Oh, yeah,
in my life.
You did.
Single ever again in my life.
Baby, but since Adalina's here, that's right. Adalina, since Adalina's on Afterwise Worldwide Radio, and she's on the Tea Club, I'm gonna officially make her. Adalina, you are now the transgender mayor of Houston. That's right, so all my transgender people, if you need a spokesperson, if you're looking for your mayor, if you wanna know your rights, you put up on Supermodel Adalina. So Adalina, since we have some people, I heard some transgender people, transgender was very big in the news this week, if you didn't know. Jeffree Star?
Stole somebody's.
You didn't see that?
You didn't see that? What should we do with Jeffree? Do you believe that story? I mean, because you know, I don't know if you know Jeffree. You don't know Jeffree.
I've been a huge fan of Jeffree Star since the MySpace days.
So we can assume that Jeffrey knows what he's doing.
Look, for everyone listening, Jeffree Star does whatever the hell Jeffree Star wants to do.
Just leave him where he's. Just leave him alone.
And then there were some assholes who happened to be black, and I'm black too. You know, I'm black, but I'm not this kind of black. I'm like, you know.
You're a free thinker black.
I'm universe black. I'm heavenly black. Heavenly black! Expensive heavenly black. That's me. That's right. Before we go, what do you think about, you know, what can we do to project, you know, because there were three transgender people in LA that got beat up.
I actually know.
You know them?
Well, I don't personally know them, like, directly, but I have friends that are in that friend group that knew them. And I've known those girls since they started their transition as well. Like, we kind of started around the same time. So basically watched them, you know, grow and transition. And so it definitely hit close to home.
Mm-hmm. What can we do to help protect your lives?
Well, definitely for one is that when they got attacked, there were a lot of bystanders and people just walking by that didn't help. Mm. Whereas, like, even though I always stay strapped and I always protect myself, and
okay, we gotta go. She's gonna go. So you said we should stay strapped.
In Texas, everyone is strapped, or everyone must be
strapped. Or with somebody who's strapped, at least.
There you go. I can go get my license now.
Okay.
But yeah, definitely, I mean, I don't understand how in California, it's such a liberal state, why no one helped. Mm-hmm. You know, three gorgeous, I mean, just besides, the, you know, the, yeah, they are gorgeous, but just three humans that needed help at the time, that no one did anything.
They just, wow.
All my single men who haven't found the right women, if you're looking for gorgeous women, just go transgender.
And just be a good person. Just be a good person. If you see somebody who needs help, help them in the ways that you can. Like, if you can call the police, the good police, call the good police. If you can fight,
good number police.
Okay, if you can fight, like,
good number police, 888.
No, but I don't support anybody getting jumped. Like, first of all, that's rude.
Especially
what? Rude. Like, that's just rude. Could have lost their lives.
It was
horrible. It's inhumane. It's inhumane.
It was like three women and what, like 8 to 10 men that were holding them.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And like, yeah,
because they're harder than them.
I saw the videos and I had a bunch of people, my friends, they were throwing bricks at them and bikes at them and knocking them out unconscious. What is wrong with people? One of them stole Eden's phone and then had her pay for her own stuff. That's just called evil. We need to come back. They're evil people out here in the world, but they're beautiful people in here, like Adalina.
So, beautiful spirits, beautiful energy, who have a purpose, like who have a calling, who are here to help people, period. Yes. Like, it's not anything negative, so why be negative towards something that's positive? That's just common sense.
Exactly. Like, and if it's not something you vibe with, then just move on.
Just leave it alone. Just let it be.
There's no good out of adding any more.
Because it's going to come back. Mm-hmm. It's going to come back to them people.
Yeah, it's going to come back. So, leg out. Leg out. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in Afterlife Worldwide Radio. I want to give a big shout out to Adalina for coming through. I'm a little upset with her because she didn't tell us if she was single or not, or if she was smashing.
Well, that means you got to come back.
That's right. We got to spill the tea, Adalina.
You got to come back and spill the tea, Adalina.
Yeah, who did you kiss last night, Adalina? Yeah. Okay. Shit like that. Adalina. Those type of things we're like to that. Right? And Danny said you still have a man voice. You could do a man voice.
What is a man voice?
A man voice.
Is that just a low voice? Like,
this is a man voice for you. Yeah, baby.
How you doing? You are sexy.
Yes. Oh, baby.
Baritone. That's what that is.
How many drinks did you have before you said that?
I just put it on the spot.
I don't know what he's talking about.
That is my last resort. That is my secret. If I do not have my gun or my switchblade on me and I need to kick some ass, you physically, Hulk.
that's when I break out that voice.
Can you, can you break out that voice? Can you break out that voice for all those fucking haters right now? Break it out so they at least know. Just one time. One time before we go, Adalina. Break it out.
This is
AfroVibes
Radio Houston.
Ladies and gentlemen, you tuned into AfroVibes Radio. It's a T-Club.
I love it.
Adalina didn't break out the voice, but trust me. Shout out to Daniela. Shout out to Soleil. I don't know where the hell Joanna is. Shout out to AfroVibes Worldwide Radio. Trent's back. We'll see you guys, what, Monday, 12 noon?
I'm down.
The show is Monday, 12 noon. Make sure you tune in. That's what my name is, Heaven Motzart. You want to say something before we get out of here, Adalina? Well, tell everybody who's your favorite DJ, because I know all those people where you work are going to be listening. Let them know.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, tell them. Tell them it's me. Tell them it's me.
It's you.
It's the most expensive DJ ever.
And your favorite radio station is AfroVibes Worldwide Radio. Adalina. That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, please round of applause.
Yeah. Thank you for coming back.
Fire!
And thank you for coming back. I appreciate you already coming back, right?
Daddy, you want to say something before we go?
I just
want to
say that I love
you. Like kisses down below?
I like the kisses
and
down
below.
And yeah, all that.
We'll see you guys later. That's your AfroVibes Worldwide Radio. T-Club, AfroVibes TV, AfroVibes Entertainment. We out.